when I was in the biology school, getting my major in biochemistry, I was very much interested in viruses. Yeah, viruses are everywhere. They infect everything. And then I realized that viruses evolve all the time. So when once you start working with viruses, you really see the things change with time, and they change so quick. My name is Santiago Elena, and I work on studying the evolution of viruses of plants, viruses that infect plants.
Viruses can be nasty. They are tiny parasites that infect the cells of plants and animals. This plant was hit with the tobacco virus.
These two plants, they have the same age. Okay, they were potted at the same time, so they were like sisters. This plant was not infected, so you see how leaves are big and green and healthy, and this is an infected plant, and you can see how leaves are small and they have all this yellowing. So these are the symptoms produced by the virus.
Pretty scary if you're a tobacco plant. But there's something even more terrifying about viruses. You just have to look a little closer. Once inside the cells of the tobacco plant, the virus takes over, forcing the plant to use its own energy to make more of the virus. Each individual has a very simple structure, and they can quickly evolve. At its core is a single strand of RNA, the building block of life. When new ones are produced, they can have slight mistakes or mutations, making them different from the previous generation. With literally trillions of replications in 1 month, you can have lots of mutations, and therefore, lots of different viruses. Compare that with animals. In 1 month, mice produce at most 1 litter of offspring. It would take them over 400,000 years to produce the same amount of offspring that a virus produces in just 1 month. In viruses, evolution happens trillions of times faster. No wonder it's hard to see evolution happening around us. But Dr. Elena has an amazing plan. He thinks we will be able to witness evolution right before our eyes. It's the evolution of the tobacco virus. To do this, he needs to use a different type of plant called Arabidopsis.
These are the plants we are going to use for infecting with the virus. They are going to get sick soon.
At first, the tobacco virus has no way of infecting the Arabidopsis. It is only programmed for the tobacco plant. But Dr. Elena thinks he can change this. If the original virus is given enough time, it may be able to adapt to the new host. To begin the experiment, Dr. Elena infects an Arabidopsis plant with the tobacco virus. At this point, almost nothing happens, because most of the virus dies out. It doesn't know how to deal with the new host. But by random chance, a few virus individuals could carry mutations, allowing them to survive. Dr. Elena extracts the remaining virus and uses it to infect another Arabidopsis. He repeats this 30 times, continuously infecting, then extracting the virus on different Arabidopsis plants. After 30 rounds of evolution, will the new virus be different from the original one? Has evolution taken place? The final step of the experiment will reveal all. Now, Dr. Elena will use the original tobacco virus to infect one Arabidopsis plant. He will compare that with the descendant of the virus, the one that has had time to evolve. We will soon see if the new tobacco virus has changed and can infect an Arabidopsis plant, or if the right mutations did not occur and it simply dies out. After just 3 weeks, it becomes obvious. The one infected with the new tobacco virus is sick.
These plants were infected 3 weeks ago, and they now show very strong symptoms. They are very small branches, very few leaves, seeds are small, so they really look very, very sick.
It seems the tobacco virus was able to evolve and infect the Arabidopsis plant. But what about the one infected with the original tobacco virus?
You have to compare these with the ones infected with ancestral virus. They clearly look different. And there's no symptoms. The plants look very healthy, very long stems, lots of flowers, lots of seeds.
It appears to be evolution. But to be sure, we need to look at the virus genome. The new virus has to be genetically different to the original population.
When we sequence the genome of the evolved virus, we only observe 3 amino acid replacements. This is a clear case of adaptive evolution. We first observed differences in phenotypes, in the effect on plants, and now we are associating those phenotypic changes to molecular changes, changes in the viral genome. So this is the case of evolution.
Just 3 small mutations make it a completely new virus. This one able to infect an Arabidopsis plant, proving that in viruses, evolution happens right before our eyes.